Welcome to Week 3 Wrap-Up. This week we talked about hypothesis testing. It's all about the hypotheses. You start with the null, or HO, and then you determine the alternative hypothesis, H1. Don't forget that the null is the status quo, or the assumed normal situation, and you're collecting evidence to prove that the alternative is true. Remember, the equal sign is always in the null hypothesis. Here are some examples of hypothesis tests for a population mean. Notice we start with the equal to and unequal to signs, where this is a two-sided test. That is, we're interested in either the population mean being now higher or lower than our value. We move on to a one-sided test, where you see the greater than sign, and another one-sided test where you see the opposite, the less than sign. Here we'd only be interested in one side of the presumed population mean. Don't forget, the equal sign always goes in the null. Here are some more examples of hypothesis tests for population proportion. Recall that proportions must be between 0 and 1. And again, we start out with the equal to, not equal to hypothesis. Go to the one-sided greater than, the one-sided less than. And if you haven't figured it out by now, the equal sign is always with the null. Now, you collect your data and make a statistical decision. That decision should clearly state whether you reject or do not reject the null hypothesis. Recall the golden rule of hypothesis testing. If P is low, HO must go. Just to make sure we're clear, that means we reject HO. And low is usually less than 0.05. Don't forget about the type 1 and type 2 errors. A type 1 error occurs when you reject the null and it is true. Type 2 errors occur when you do not reject the HO and it is false. Refer to the p-value to help you make your statistical decision and conclusion. See you in week 4.